Well, what's up? Welcome. Yesterday, I made it so that everybody that's been waiting for a long time to play Songbringer, people that have pre-ordered the game like over 6 months ago, been waiting all year. Oh, I just like, it was so good to just be like, yo, here, free upgrade. That was pretty nice, right? It's nice of me. I'm such a good person. Anyways, now I'm fixing some bugs. Got a lot of bug reports, some important things related to input, controller issues, Jib acting all weird. Look, this is Jib in human mode. Hold on a second. Let me make sure that's right. Yeah, Jib's in human mode and he's just not moving, right? If I go to Jib controls, I'm pressing up and he's barely moving. It's like he's stopping. He's like stopping every time I press it. I have to like con. If you hold down a button, he doesn't even move at all. So that's one little bug. He starts working again, of course, if you put him in AI mode. He's like, oh yeah, I'm fine. So some little issue there. So yeah, I'm gonna go and just start working on these little bugs. Welcome to the stream, everybody. Welcome to the YouTube video, whatever you're watching. Welcome. Welcome all. Merry Christmas. Happy holidays! Okay, so starting on my Trello list, there's a few things that are kind of high priority things. This is a quick, I'm gonna start with a quick, really easy one. Smaller text for the German delete and enter keys. Something, there's a long bit of text for those German keys. Let's start by not skipping the menu. Set the language to German and figure this out. I think it's just a long bit of text. Washing is a race? Yeah. New spiel. Spiel? New spiel? There we go. Start word. And floss. These are two. These guys are just like new. Now, first of all, let's try shortening the text a little bit by using, this is going to be a title scene. Oh wait, scenes. This is where it does the controller keyboard. So it pushes back a bunch of, oh no, this is actually in interfaces. I'm just gonna code in Xcode today. I've been playing around with Vim a lot, loving it actually. But I'm gonna be using Xcode because I'm faster still with Xcode, and I got a lot of bugs I want to get fixed because I want to patch this and put it up on Steam tonight. I don't want these bugs to be affecting people. Where's the keyboard one? Where it creates the keyboard. There it is, seed. There we go. Okay, so it creates all the letters. And then here it is, backspace and delete. Okay, so let's do an onCreate function, c.onCreate. It takes a choice ref. So inside our choice, we got c.menu item. Wait, no, c.label? Yeah, c.label. Not sure if this is necessary, but. Oh, wait, oh! I have a new thing. It's called Safe Call. It's such a great little thing. Man, I can't believe I didn't do this so long ago. So if c.label is good, then call C dot label. No, wait. I want to call kit letter spacing. Spacing? Change spacing. One of those. Spacing delta negative one. I'm gonna skip this next time. Okay, new spiel, normal. And did Floss does they still look? Well, let's see if this even worked. Set that to negative two. Put this to get that compiling. Skip to menu. Where's that at? There it is. Skip to menu. All right, C.label. Oh, this is loss. Oh, int is loss. I was looking at the wrong one. Oh, no wonder. Same for you. Both y'all, same thing. Let's try negative two first. That's weird. So in German, backspace is Enf. Sounds like enter. It's confusing me. Man. Aha! There we go! Oh! Messes up when you switch to it. I wonder why it doesn't remember that. I guess this should probably be somewhere else. Particularly when we are pushing a choice. Oh no, this is when it's creating the choice. Creating the choices. Push choice, remove choice, clear. It's like interface create, here it is. It goes and it creates the menu, goes through its choices, creates all the choices. Each one of the choices It creates, okay, so it does a change spacing, but only if it's really long. And then I think it's this label glitch, which is doing font glitch, which is the issue here. And these can be save calls. So why would set font? Hold on. Let's see if this is the issue even. Oh, Shazzle. Means I should go back to ugh. Start with those. Now still shit. So if it's a keyboard, which means that has bits. Boogie, what's up, man? How you doing today? What's new in your world, man? What you been doing? You get any new drones or anything? What do you want for Christmas, man? Going good? It's going really good here too. Yeah. Things are great. I had a lot of fun yesterday giving out free upgrades to everybody that's been waiting like more than 6 months for Songbringer. That was great. Felt good. I gotta give a big Christmas gift. You want the NES Classic and a PS4? Sweet, man. Nice. I like it. You know what you want. So I'm fixing a few bugs here. I already got some bug reports and stuff from people playing the game that have been, all the new people or whatever. You never know what you want, but to this time you do. Yeah. Did you see those little new drones they have that are like the size of a quarter? I saw it on like futurism.com or something like that. Okay, anyways, so label glitch. Let's turn off the font glitching. Right, there. Ah, it's not that. Is it the scale Y glitch? Might be the scale Y glitch. You haven't seen them? They look pretty cool. Firefox. I don't want Firefox. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Is this it, Arius? I forget. Yeah, this is it, man. Check it, it's an inch. What's up, Kavarni? Rocket Bunny, how was the dance, man? You kind of like Lua? It does not sound stupid at all to me, man. I know I was kind of trash talking Lua the other day, but wait, you have one of those? What you? Oh, had? What'd you do? You flew it into your toilet and flushed it accidentally? Something I would do. Be like, whoops. You did? Tell me again. I'm like a grandpa or something right now. Okay, it's neither of those. You crashed it? That's it. Slam it. Bang it. Crash it. Yeah. It might just be better to use a smaller font. You was more like a rave? Really? Oh, that's right. You got kissed a lot. I remember now. You have a cold, though? Is it because the girls kissed you too much? You got a cold from it? That sucks. Oh, it fell out of the sky. Oh, yeah, you're not, man. This is your first American flu. Oh, that sucks. All right, we'll do this. Up here. Console is keyboard. The best book on C++ in English? Well, what are you talking about? Beginner C++ or intermediate C++? Okay, so we'll set an auto ref to the font we're going to use, and if it's a keyboard and the text size is greater than 1, then we want to use K font small. Otherwise, we want to use the normal font, K font. So there. And we use the font here and here. I think that's going to be a smarter way to do this. Intermediate, huh? You never read a book in my life? Is that really the truth? I would believe it. I do have some good, I have a recommendation for a book. This is called, what's it called? Oh, more effective C++. This is for intermediate people. Intermediate C++. Scott Myers' books. Here's probably a good way to go. Look at Scott, his list of books. He's got a bunch of them. But these are excellent books on C++ that will really teach you the more intermediate stuff and like just to get better at C++, you know? Yeah, so the one I was thinking of was more effective C++, but there's a bunch of them. Effective mod. See, this one's 2014. The last time I read it was, yeah, I read this one a hell of a long time ago. Before 2005, he had like the second edition or whatever of this one, Effective C++. But I like this one, Effective Modern C++. This looks good because C++ has changed a lot in the last few years. The haircut, he's totally legit. He has not cut his hair since 1970. Or no, this is more like 1982 right here. Hell yeah, Scott Myers. No, really, he's actually really does have a really good advice on C++. Right, did that work? I just want to see a smaller font. Yes, that works. Does this work? Oh, shizzle. He's a YouTube fan? Damn it, I'm using up my time on kind of a silly little bug here. This is not even a bug. This is just more of a little stylistic thing. But I'm so close. I'm so close. I've got to finish this. So when you change choices, it's what is this one called? This function? Select. I think it's called select. New choice. Check the current item. Set up scrolling stop actions. Here it is. Stop action. And then. No, this is the tint action. Where's the other action? Font glitch. Aha. So why didn't you call label get BM font file path? Pretty sure that will return the entire font file path. Maybe. Wait a minute. Maybe it won't. Let's see what happens here. And if we need to, we can just call kid base name. I believe I got a base name function. Did I make that public? Base name, come on. Aye, the time I have to wait for the autocomplete to come up. Ah, there it is. String path, string base name. Oh. So that would be base name, old font. Is that right? Okay, we'll see what happens here. Basically, instead of glitching from one font to another, or I mean from these preset fonts, we want to glitch from the font that we have already set. Okay. Old font was, yeah, oh good. We don't even have to use base name. But would this work if we called base name on itself? Pause equals path dot rfind blah. returns negative, so base name equals, oops, okay, so this function is probably borked. Oh, it worked still, but oh, can't guarantee that would work on Windows. So if pause is not equal to string and pause, then do this. Okay, I'm glad this worked. And this could even be just an auto ref. And that should make it so it glitches correctly. You instantly want to watch this YouTube video? It's so majestic. It's like a lion. Oh, it's so great, right? I just watched this funny-ass movie called Sword and the Sorcerer, I think. And it was from 1982. And everybody's hair was like that. People had the funniest beards. Yay, it works. Woo! Okay. Does that work in English? Yeah, that's fine. It's fine, man. It's fine. Okay, good. I like it. I like it, I like it, I like it. Let's undo those other changes. Where were they? Scanning for code, I commented. That's good. Want that. The other little bit is in, what was that? Oh, create for seed. Don't need these. Okay, and review. What's up, Loki Kappa? All right, we just checked if it's keyboard. If it is, we use the small font. Nothing else has changed, really. Nothing. Good. And then when it does the glitchy thing, it makes sure to glitch from the old font. To the alien font and back. And then we added one little bug fix to base name, just in case base name doesn't find its trailing slash character. This looks good. Checking it in. Use the small font for the ent del keys on the seed menu. No, not Z. X. Z and X are so close together. Not much. Oh man, what am I up to? I'm working on these little, you know, these little bug fixes and stuff. Yesterday, I upgraded everybody that's been waiting for Songbringer from like more than 6 months. I upgraded everybody that's been like, that's paid basically $16 or to, you know, they've given me money. These people have given me money and I'm like, they've been waiting a long time. All these people have been expecting to play the game this year. So since people weren't able to play the game this year, or I mean, since the game wasn't finished this year, I felt bad. And I wanted to upgrade people, so I upgraded a lot of people yesterday, and I'm really excited to have the game out to them. And I've got a lot of bugs that people have reported, and I'm working on those right now. As you can see, there's a lot of them. Yesterday I had 80 bugs, today I have 112. So, but anyways, I'm just getting to the most important ones today, and gonna do a little patch for the Steam version tonight. Okay, there. Archive that. Now, the next one is this one where Jib is really slow when he's in human mode. In fact, it's like he just inches along like an inchworm. It's kind of funny. Let's go skip to the menu, or skip the menu, and then Jib will need to be in human mode, and he doesn't even work. Isn't that cool of me? I'm such a good person, right? But it is kind of nice, though, to be in the holiday spirit, kind of giving and stuff. Feels good. You bought an alpha 5 years ago? It's still just in beta? Whoa. Which game? Okay, Jib's fine in human mode. But you put him in human, or I mean, he's fine in AI mode, but you put him in human mode and he just can't even move. Okay, let's figure that out. Why is he just inching along? Typical alpha games on Steam, right? There's too much of that going on. I think that's kind of crazy. Kenshi? I haven't heard of this game. Oh, squad-based RPG? Cool. Oh, interesting. This looks like it's kind of got a grand scope. You got all this character customization and squads and open-endedness. I can see why it's probably taking a long time. But it looks good, actually. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, very grand. Yeah. Huh. I'm wondering if now it's, is it Jib? Is Jib like getting his input canceled? Oh, you know what? Let's turn on controller verbosity. And then we'll change the controller verbosity to be player 2. In fact, actually, let's make it so we can customize that. And if I set controller verbosity to 2, that'll mean show me player 2's input. So show player 1 or 2's input component. And okay, so we get the player index equals clamp by the verbosity minus 1, clamp that between 0 and the number of hero eids. Oh, it's a small group of developers and limited funds, yeah. Which is kind of it's kind of the indie thing, right? Small team, limited funds. But dang, if they're a small team and they're making that beautiful of a game, that's pretty commendable. Game scene, heroes.size, how about that? Minus 1. And then we can grab the input there and show me that player's input. Yeah, so we got verbosity. So verbosity zero, we're not gonna get into here. Verbosity one, this is gonna become zero. Verbosity two, this will become possibly the second player. Shit, this would work for as many players as we needed. Okay, so we've got Jib's input. What if I press up? Oh, it does flicker. Okay, so let's slow down time. 148, 148. It's as if I let go of the input. So I'm holding down the up arrow for Jib. And it just goes 148. One, it means inputs button has been pressed, I think. Four means, oh shit, let's look those up. Yeah, it does look like Fallout, huh? Okay, button state, not start, state. Button, is not that button? Oh, there it is. Just K button, just pressed. Oh, right. So one means it was just pressed. Two means it is pressed. Four means it was just released. And eight means it was released a while ago or whatever. Not this tick. Okay, so what's happening is I'm pressing the button and holding it, but the input system thinks that I've released it. Ah, and the only difference between my input and Jib's input is that Jib is an AI, or has an AI component. I bet you it's the AI system, the way it clears its directions and stuff. Oh, wait, let's actually, oh, this is going to be a good confirmation. If I press Jib's scan button and hold that, I can tell whether his scan can hold. Saladong's is like, ship it. P.S. up. What's up, buddy? Okay, that's the right button. Where is it? There it is, scan. Okay, so I'm pressing scan and holding. Yeah, okay, so it goes 1, 2, and I let go and it goes 4, 8. Yeah, there you go, just proved it. All right, so his regular input works. It's just that it's clearing his direction. I bet you anything it's the AI system, the way it clears input if you... Where does it clear that input? I think it's in set. No, where is it? It might be here in apply input. But I think there's something else here. There used to be something else. Maybe I actually changed that, the way that worked. I think there's a little bit of a better way to do that. And I was like, oh, I'll do that here. It's a timer, spawn count, reset target, stucks, pathing. AI behavior. Yeah, it must be here in apply input. And then, yeah, it goes into here in the E input set button down. First of all, is it getting here at all? Let me just make sure this is actually the culprit. Are you the culprit? Show yourself, culprit. Take off the bandana that you wear around your face. Reveal yourself, culprit. All right. Oh yeah, that was it. Okay. So it works totally fine if I remove that. Okay, cool. The culprit's been revealed. So the question is, does it actually ever set an AI dir for Jib? I want to know that first. The Mesa Rapper? Parappa the Rapper? Alright, so if e.id, no, we'll just go e.name, .name equals jib log jibdir. And I'm using a log statement here because I don't wanna, this is gonna be a lot of log statements or a lot of things. Right? Parappa the Rapper, remember that? It's a good game. I love those like PlayStation 1 games. Alright, now back to the log. Yeah, check it out. Jib's dir is -1 the whole time. He never sets a dir. The problem is this function here, set button down. He doesn't even realize that if you press compass dir none. Still tries to do stuff. See that? AI dir true. Cause is down, blah blah blah. This is a kind of weak sauce. So if D equals K dir none. Wait. Oh, will this break all the other AI? You never played it? Antique. Super Mario 3, of course. Just ask the droidsmith to fix it. Yeah, man, I won. I rigged it. Hell yeah. I'll make myself win again. I'll give myself 600 points next time. Okay, I have a feeling that if I change this, I might break every some other AI. Because the AI has to let go. McDur Dur. Am I? Yep. Yeah, Sal Dogs, you gave yourself a point. HD, what's up, man? Okay, so my programmer sense is going crazy on this line here. If I return from this function here, I just know that it's probably going to break. So I'm thinking what needs to happen is, if the direction is none, it needs to scan through its existing input. No. Oh, wait. I got a better idea. Yeah, I got a way better idea than that. That's kind of important to be able to use the none here, but one thing that Jib doesn't have that other AI has is a behavior. So it really should only apply input if it has a behavior. If AI.behavior. Totally nepotism. will be to increase his salary. I think he already started doing that with his children. Or whatever. Or maybe those are just his promises. Is valid. If it's okay. If we don't have a behavior, we don't need to be applying input. Pretty sure. Yeah, we're certain. We're certain of this. Everything's fine. It's all good. Yay, Jib works now. But does all the other AI? Let's confirm. Those work. These guys look like they're working. You're all dead. These guys look fine. What about this boss? Scan him, Jib. Get him, Jib. Check it out. Jib's totally distracting the boss. Good job, Jib. Yes, Jib. You're done. This is actually really helpful. You need to play this set with a friend, so this boss is really easy. Right? Possibly. I wouldn't put it past him to pay himself only a dollar. You know what? I think this is good, right? It's only a two-line change. We fixed Jib's input. Let's make sure Vel still works. Because Vel has a behavior. Vel, 2, Jib, 0. We want 9 Jibs. Vel, you good? You're human. Okay, you're human. Oh no! Vel breaks because she has a behavior. Shazzle. Okay, so we need a better solution. Because Vel has a behavior, we need to be smarter about how this all works. Like, okay, so just to recap, if you're paying attention to the code here, what's going on is that Jib moves like a little inchworm because his input keeps getting truncated by this set button down function, which thinks that he's pressing buttons and releasing buttons. So I fixed it by saying, okay, if you don't have a behavior, don't do this. But that's not actually accurate. I got it. We could say if the AI had input. Yeah. Think this will work. AI system. Bool had input. So I'll set a variable that just defines if the AI had a direction before this all started. So bool had input equals e.ai.dir is not equal to k.dir none. That's a const. And then I could pass that in here, had input, and then we only need to call set buttons down if we have input. E.ai.dir is not equal to k.dir none, or we had input. Either one of those cases, we definitely need to call set button down. Okay, let's hope that that's a better solution. In fact, I can just delete this because I know that's not a good enough solution there. What's this? Why am I calling apply input? Oh, input, compressor, Excel factor, media movement, not stuck. So I guess we want to pass true here. Just so that it definitely calls some input function. It definitely starts off the input on the right foot here. Right, my input's fine. Our input's fine. Let's see if some enemies are working. These guys are cool. You guys are okay. Good. I think this is a good solution. It's just smarter about how it applies input for AI. If an AI did not have any input at all, it doesn't need to go and try and like what's it like basically unset the input, you know, has to release the button. So yeah, it doesn't need to release buttons if it didn't have any input at all. Which it was basically just releasing buttons all the time, every single AI, no matter if they had a behavior, no matter what. So this is a lot smarter. So let's see, let's make sure Jib still works, and let's go back to this boss too. looking good. And we also got projectiles. Projectiles are still working, which was that with that last line of code I was checking there. Shot. Got moving all that. Cool. Let's make sure Jib's working. What's up, Kappa.B? Development's going really great today, man. Thanks for asking. I'm working on some bugs. Yesterday, I upgraded everybody that's been waiting like 6 months or more to play Songbringer. Everybody that's already paid for the game, you know? These people rightfully deserve to play the game, so I did a little Christmas gift and upgraded everybody to play the beta. Even though the game's not finished, and the deal was these guys get to play the game when it's finished. I just upgraded everybody anyway, because they've been waiting so long. A lot of people are expecting to play the game in 2016, so. So yep, I'm working on some bugs, because there's plenty of them. And I want to get some of them fixed. The more important bugs got to get fixed and updated today. So this is a good little bug fix. Let's turn off this input controllers thing. Just make sure that without that, the game still functions fine. Yep, I can move. And Jib can move. And if I set Jib back to AI mode? Oops. Yeah, cool. He turns back into his happy little self. Nice. Oh, I should check Vel too. So Vel goes back and forth between AI mode. Yeah. Thanks, Alan. How do you access the beta? If you paid for the game at the $16 level or whatever, and you would have already got an email. So it's only if you paid for it and you've been waiting six months or more. If you've already paid for the $32 version, you already have beta access. And now, basically, if you paid for the $16 version and you've been waiting 6 months, then you should already have an email, and you just open up your email, click the link, and it goes to Humble Bundle's website. Humble Bundle, you claim the page, and then you just get your Steam key right there, and you can install it. And if you didn't pay for the game 6 months ago or whatever, and you do want to play it now, there's two ways you can get a key. You can buy the $32 version at songbringer.com/pre-order, or you can raffle points here on the stream. So you just go, you need to be a follow, you need to follow the stream. You might be aware of all this, but I'm just gonna say it anyways. Botfu, when he's around, he's tracking points and stuff. Maybe he's not around. Oh, there. Yeah, he's around. So, yeah, you got commands from Botfu. And basically, if you're following, you start racking up points. And if you rack up 4,000 points, it's guaranteed you're going to win a Steam key. You just got to raffle your points with the... I think it's the raffle command. Oh, you paid. Oh, you already paid. All right. So, when did you pay exactly? I know I'm hoarding points like a madman. Steam key, right, that's the command, yeah. Point embezzlement. Oh, you ordered a couple weeks ago? Yeah, so the deal was that basically people that have been waiting 6 months or more are the ones that got upgraded. So, yeah. So, sorry, but you're going to have to keep waiting. If you really want to, you can upgrade your order or whatever. Since you already paid $16, you can upgrade. I thought it was on here. Oh yeah, here it is. This PayPal button. So if you go to this songbringer.com/pre-order and then you just do this PayPal button, you can send me another $16 and then you can play the beta. So that'll get you upgraded. Or you can just wait and raffle off your points. Steve Tramby, what's up, man? Damn me, why is that? Because you only ordered a month ago? Oh, I know. I'm sorry. But these people have been waiting like seriously, some people were expecting to play the game like in March or whatever. And that was a long time ago. They pre-ordered the game and they're like, "Yeah, I get to play this game and wow, it's going to come out soon in 2016, no problem." And then they weren't able to play it. So I just wanted to make sure that all those people got upgraded. Cool. All right, you just give me a hard time. Nice. Okay, I think I can fix that bug, right? Yes. All right, so the AI system is smarter. Oh wait, no, I was gonna check if Vel works, right? Just gonna make sure that Vel, if you switch back and forth between AI. You approve of this? All right, Steve. I'm glad. I'm glad. Yeah, I ran it by some people on the stream last week just to make sure. Oh yeah, if she's in AI mode, she can kind of like mix her input. That's kind of a bug, I guess. Her AI and human input are both count. Okay, so I'm in human mode right now, just running around. What happens if she runs off? Oh yeah, she can't run off the screen. And now if I go back to AI mode, yep, she comes back. Cool. Okay, good. This is a good bug fix. Jib is no longer an inchworm. You want to spend your points on a life-size raw cardboard cutout? For reasons? Oh man, we gotta make this a reality. Add input, right. So this is a smart way to handle releasing buttons. This is all this is about, is just AI releasing the buttons that they've been pressing. So an AI only tries to release its buttons if it had input or it has input. And that's what fixes Jib and doesn't break anything else. Hopefully. Jib is no longer an inchworm. Yes, the body pillow and the life-size cardboard cutout. All right, another bug off the list. Another one bites the dust. All right, the next one on the bug list here is the meditation door does not open for some people sometimes. I know it worked for me when I just tested it, and I know it worked for me when I play tested the game the other day. So I'm thinking this is either. Ooh, oh yeah. Okay, so I have people's saves. I'm just gonna use somebody else's save for this. I think this guy. Yeah. This is the one. Yeah, goo. Positions, where is he at? And this 322. Yes, this is probably it. That is such a good slogan. Man, that body pillow would sell like hotcakes. Somebody wants to make $1 million. There you go. Okay, so we want to go override my saves. Oh yeah, I'll just go. All right, copy my current saves. Just back it up and move or copy the desktop one. So I'm gonna play with this guy's save file. Oh wait, but I want my own. I want some debug keys and stuff. I need this stuff and this thing. These are all importante. In fact, these should all just be together from now on. And back that up. And copy this. How many are currently in the beta? How many people? A few thousand, maybe? But I don't know that's how many people have keys. I really don't know how many people are actually playing it. Oh, that's a good question. That's a great question, Steve. I'm interested in hearing other people's feedback on that. What do you guys think? Is it cool if a game sends like anonymous data back to its server without asking? So you think it's fine as long as the save games don't have users' personal info? Mm-hmm. I was facing this exact same question on the latest update, and I chose to just ask the user first. But I was like, I wonder if this, oh, is anybody going to care? But then I realized that I probably would care. I'm one of those people that always says no when I'm like, do you want to send this data to this company? I'm usually like, no, by default. But if it's a crash report, then I'm like, yes, send this right now. But I always prefer to have a piece of software ask me before it does stuff. I don't know. It's my personal opinion. Oh, as long as you disclosed it. Right, yeah. As long as the player knows. Save stuck to saves. All right. Okay, so this is the player's saves file. I'm going to hack in my own settings here. I want this and this. Okay. That's a sequel. All right, goo. Hopefully this is, not my keys. Oh, what keys is he using? Ah. I don't know. We need some keys, man. So I'm going to use my bindings. Oh, he was using WSAD. That's why I couldn't get it to work. All right. right, so I'm curious about something here. So the issue here is that the issue that's been reported is that you have the meditate skill, you use it here, and it does the animation, but the door doesn't open. Hopefully the door is not open for me either. Shit, it opened. Huh. I hate bugs like this. Okay, the first thing to do is to check out the data. The switches in particular. Yeah, we got all... Okay, so the player definitely got all three of the switches. So that part was good. And he got the meditate. But wait, this part's weird. It's almost as if he got the meditate first. Because I think the... Oh, or it just... When he saved, it just saved these in that order. Okay, that might have been it. So if I delete... If he doesn't have meditate... Let's see what happens. All right, Ishni. Right on, Steve. Well, it's not going to be a spoiler alert stream today. Oh, I want to skip the menu. Skip menu! This reminds me of a regular show episode. Does anybody else watch the regular show? Okay, let's see if this fails. Wait a minute, what if you meditate way down here? Should still open the door. I need a scissor, right? What? One more day till day 500. I don't even know what's gonna do. What are we gonna do? Shit, it worked again. Ay. Ay, ay, man. So two people so far have reported this bug where this door doesn't open. And it worked fine for me, even though I'm using their save file. What about release mode? Let's go into release mode, see if there's something funky with that. Or maybe Windows. We can launch Windows. I know, right? The regular show. Oh, yeah, I think it is just called regular show. Not the. Now that you mention it. But yeah, it's a cartoon. It's great. It's so great. The two main characters play lots of video games. They're just like, I don't know. I feel like I know them. It's one of those cartoons that's fun even if you're an adult. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Okay, I'm trying to catch a bug, which is... You know what? Maybe I think the next thing to try is Windows. If this doesn't work. You've never heard of it? Rocket Bunny, you would love it. I'm sure you would. You'd get it. Maybe it might actually start with the, I don't know. I can't even remember. I've seen like thousands of episodes. I've seen millions of episodes. I can't even remember if it has the word the at the beginning. Mordecai. Is he a blue jay or a purple martin? That's freaking genius. It is, right? I don't know what he is. Yeah, there's like a billion shows these days. What about you guys? What's cool? What's like the latest thing you've been watching as a show or a television thing or a series? What's new? You're watching Gotham? Is it good? My lady says Gotham's good. Okay, let's see if this fails. Come on, fail! You finished up Westworld? What's up, Akuma? It's great, nice. He's a blue jay, really? I never knew that. He's a blue jay, not a purple martin. I'm gonna get Windows launching. No, I should wait till this finishes indexing. Or no, actually, I'm gonna switch back to debug mode because that didn't help. There, okay. How to catch this bug? What's going on? Well, yeah, the next thing to do is to look at the code. Westworld! Grand Tour, huh? Nice, Akuma. Re-index anyways. Okay, while it's re-indexing, when it's use meditate, that's the thing that opens up the door. So I'm gonna look at the code and figure out what could possibly be making the animation to go off, but the door to not open. Because that's what people have been reporting. Like the meditation animation happens, but the door does not open. Okay, so do open boss doors is separate from do NM. It slowly consumes you. It's a disease. Okay, so how could it get do open boss doors but not do an M? Do open boss doors happens if you have K flag before boss and K flag swordless, and the number of switches for the current Z is greater than or equal to 3, and the door system is locked. And is that a const? That should, let's see, if I change this to const, does it break it? Because it really should be const. Yeah, and then suddenly go months. What are you laughing at? The stop all actions? I use stop all actions a lot. Oh, Steve. By the way, I wanted to ask you, what's going on with Cocos 4.0? If you happen to know anything. I saw a whole bunch of posts about 4.0, like, in 2015, but now it's like all the way through 2016, and nobody said anything about 4.0. You ran out of hot chocolate. You gotta get to the store fast, Rocket Bunny. This is crucial. So how does it get do an M? It gets do an M if it's do open bossors or do rock face. Oh, so what that means, okay, also this should be const, if possible, unless that can change. No, I don't think it can. Okay, so both those should be const. Let's keep it simple here. How much do you want me to rant about it? Rant a little. I want a little ranting, man. I want to hear what you have to say. Cocos 4 was canceled, really? It might be. From what I heard. I haven't heard anything about it. And also this. Oh, right. The Cocos creator. Oh, good. Yeah, I know. I saw a post from Walzer, and he's got a whole bunch of pressure from his investors or whatever to do the Cocos creator thing. Because that's what makes their company money. In meetings, huh? Dang, man. So how could this have gotten to be true, but the door not opened? Let's go with that theory. So schedule. I guess it could have gone this way. Oh, wait a minute. The player does not have switch 8. Rocket, right? Huh. Man, makes me kind of want to code my own engine for the next game. Or take like Cocos 2DX and minify it or something. And I really hope Jai comes out soon. The last videos I watched from Jonathan Blow, it looks like he's getting pretty close. He's got it all set up with LLVM and stuff now. Game Maker's OG, huh? Say, if I... All right, let's do this. Say we have Meditate to start with. What's up, Mr. Frenic? What's up, bro amigos? Okay, what I'm gonna do is do this meditate thing and then save. And I I think what it'll do is add switch 8. Whoops. To the saves? Oh, it did not. Really? Oh, it sets 1 and then it sets 0 again afterwards. Oh, so that's why it doesn't set. Oh. Sweet, you just got off work? Right on, man. Happy off work time. I'm trying to catch a little bug here. What I'm working on is some bugs and stuff because some new people are playing the game. Everybody that's been waiting for Songbringer for more like 6 months or more, I just upgraded them all so they can play the beta version. So just fulfilling on the promise that they would be able to play the game this year. And I've got a bunch of bug reports. I'm trying to fix the most important bugs that are kind of showstoppers for people that are preventing people from enjoying the game right now. One of them is this, where the meditation door here just stays locked. I'm trying to figure out what logic could possibly cause it to stay locked. This right here, if the world pause changes, but I don't know how the hell the world pause would change, unless maybe the pause was wrong. Here's another thing that should be const. Pop some bottles. Wait, can the story system possibly be trying to do rock face? Rock face! You've been doing bug hunts too? What are you doing bug hunts for? What is it that you do? I'm on a bug hunt. So this would have to have rock face and Z0, so this would never happen. And it has to have a special pattern. There's so many things that have to have. So this is likely not true. Do rock face. So players reported that the animation happened. So that probably means that it was either do open boss doors or do rock face. I just determined that rock face is probably not true. So this is like a logic puzzle. You remember those? Oh, you set the work kind of in crunch mode? Nice. What are you guys working on? If you can say. Yeah, Steve, I will definitely let you know for sure. Yeah, like a fork of, I think a fork of Cocos 2DX with it minified would be really cool. And hell yeah, if I started doing that, I would definitely make it open source. Right? I mean, it'd be stupid not to. Okay, so if it wasn't Rock Face, then it was do open boss doors. And that means that this was true. Okay, so that means I probably don't need to be worrying about looking at this logic or that logic or this logic. Door system is locked. This door system is locked again. It looks for all the door components. And if any of them are locked, it returns true. And that would definitely happen if the player couldn't get through the door. So that makes sense. Yeah, you were talking about that, the BGFX thing. That's cool, man. Yeah, let me know if you do end up doing that, man. I'll take a look. You're rewriting your game engine. Oh, sweet, man. I heard about BGFX from Steve. So what if I comment that out? It's the only place that uses pause. Oh, pause is an auto ref. I still don't think that would be the issue, but that might actually help things right there if I take that out and not be a reference. Nerd Kingdom, huh? You customize the Cocos console? Oh, nice, Steve. That's cool. Nerd Kingdom. Open. Oh, cool. That's background. Oh, BGFX uses DirectX and metal, huh? Nice, this looks beautiful. Right. You're trying out Lua with Love 2D? Rocket Bunny, that's so cool. You're experimenting with like so many different engines and stuff. Rocket Bunny, have you found anybody to game jam with up there in Seattle yet? Oh, their API is kind of weird, huh? Okay, I don't think that would have been it. Oh, you know what? I still haven't checked Windows. I really should. Let's check Windows. Maybe this fails on Windows for some reason. Yes, I'm using a not genuine copy of Windows. So bad of me, right? But I already got a real copy of Windows on my other partition. On my actual computer. What do you guys think? Is it bad? Is it bad of me to be using a fake copy of Windows in my virtual machine because I don't want to pay for yet another copy of Windows? No one in your class even knows what RAM means? Oh. Pirate. I'm a pirate. I know. I'm a modern day pirate. I just ignore this activate Windows Now thing every time. You think it's dangerous to do this part of your business? Yeah, it probably is, huh? Okay, let's get this in debug mode. Full screen's not supported? What? Definitely wet. Yes, best talk ever. Wet? I don't know if you guys have seen this before. This is kind of cool. I've got my my Windows build all set up so that it actually builds onto my Mac partition into this build folder. So it shares everything. If I actually type in code here on Windows and then I go back to my VMware Fusion and rebuild here, it actually rebuilds that code or whatever. So it's pretty sweet. I like it. It's all thanks to Steve, actually. I was talking with Steve on, and he was telling me about VMware and Parallels. Hmm. Yeah. Cross-platform Swift. Your Christmas list, all the components to make a Raspberry Pi. Oh, sorry, Raspberry Pi. I don't know why I call it Pi. I'm thinking it's in Spanish. Yeah, VMware is pretty nice. I was like, this is the best tool. VMware really is the best tool that I've come across in a long time. It's so great. It can run Songbringer. It can run like OpenGL code and stuff. So well. Like I've tried what's the other one? I tried the free thing, VM. What's the free one? VirtualBox. I used VirtualBox for a while, and it just has such bad OpenGL support. But this, man, VMware is sick. Really, really good. Man, I miss the days of Cocos 2D, the old Cocos 2D. The old Cocos 2D compiled so fast. It had such a small little code base and it was so awesome. It wasn't full of tons of bloat. So he's calling it fiber, huh? Restart PK. No, my neck's not tattooed. Is yours? I think neck tattoos are cool. I just probably couldn't get one. My mom would freak out. She'd be like, "What did you do to yourself? You already tattooed all your arms. Why did you tattoo your neck?" Okay, so let's see if this breaks. Come on, break! Break! Breaking windows! Tell me it's a Windows thing. I want to catch this bug. I'm on a bug hunt. I got my spear ready. Yeah, I consider VMware or any kind of like virtual machine to be almost an indispensable tool for cross-platform development. Thank you, Steve. Thank you for turning me on to VMware. Because seriously, before this, I had a Windows partition and a Linux partition, and that was kind of a slow way to do it all. I had to reboot and recompile in all those platforms. But now I got VMware. Come on, break. Do the animation, but don't open the door. Damn it. The door opened up still on Windows. Why are players getting this bug? Okay, well, let's try one more thing. Let's try the Windows release build. All right, Ishni, see you, man. Well, I'll let that compile. Hold on. Let's look at this logic while it's compiling. I think logically, the only thing that could be happening here is that, because this is so unlikely that the world pause would have changed, the player is just sitting there in the same point. The item also is not something that would just randomly change. The thing that probably might have happened is it either didn't lock or it didn't open. Is that possible? Slalden dogs. Am I multi-threading? No. But Cocos 2DX does. Dieharders, what's up? What's up, So Rob? Yeah, so Cocos 2DX has a renderer thread. I believe it's got a couple other threads it uses, but my own Songbringer source code is just completely single-threaded. I believe in the simplicity of that. I really like a simple engine, but I do think that it's pretty necessary to have a rendering thread in today's world. So I'm just glad that Cocos 2DX handles that part for me, and I can just think completely in a single-threaded way. Yeah, it's probably not a race condition because all the game's logic is all in one thread. Well, good suggestion. Good suggestion. You saw a Jib thread? Jib should just have his own thread. Can Vel use Jib's thread? No. We demand a Jib thread. The players demand it. Have you been stepping through the debugger? Oh, no, I haven't. I haven't tried stepping through the debugger. You know, that's a good idea. I probably should. But it's just worked. I'm trying to find a situation where it doesn't work for me, so then I can go and step through the debugger. Jib thread parallelizes infinitely. Okay, let's see if this makes it break. This is the Windows release build. Sometimes it doesn't start because of VMware, and it's using a network drive, and Windows is like, this is a network drive. This is Windows 7 too. There it goes. Windows does not like network drive. Okay, come on. Fail for me, bug. Show yourself, bug. Why did two players report this, and I can't make it happen, even with their save file? Still nothing. Damn it. Okay, I guess the next thing to do is to look at the logical situations that might be happening. Steam OS percent check? Oh, Steam OS. Oh, so the bug is that those big doors there aren't opening for some players sometimes. So the thing is, you're supposed to use the meditate skill here, and that opens up this door, these big doors. And yeah, so two players reported that it just doesn't work for them. What if I stand really far away from the door? Or wait, what if I stand really close to the door? Yeah, I'm having trouble reproducing this bug. I don't know what's going on or why. Oh, what's that? Oh, that's just, he's caught on the edge there. So wait, what are you talking about, Steve, with the Steam OS percent? What is that? How much progress have they made on Steam OS? Okay, that didn't bring it. Okay, I gotta look at this logic. It sets the lock, it unlocks the doors and then opens the doors. So Yeah, you think so? I know, this is such a non-deterministic bug. Ambient. Yeah, Linux is awesome, isn't it? I love Linux. What's this SteamOS thing? Oh, wow. Here's an interesting one, VR headsets. It's mostly the Vive. Not the Oculus. Interesting. Mac hardware ownership. Mostly MacBook Pros. Number of CPUs per computer. Mostly one, some most, I guess half one, half four. Mostly Nvidia. Mostly Intel. Oh, Rocket Bunny, maybe far off to the side. Let me try that. But I know, I'm pretty sure I saw a screenshot from somebody and they were. Yeah, actually, I should go look at that screenshot really quick. If you sacrifice the right number of virgins? Don't think so. So this would have unlocked the door. I guess the one thing that would make this fail is if the door condition wasn't correct. Don't think that would happen. There's your problem then. King nothing? You know what? Let's try that. Maybe if you're not facing the door. I can't see why that would affect it, but it's worth a shot. More sacrifices. Okay, face the other way. See, it automatically makes him face back that way when he does this animation. But maybe that was it. You never know. Wait, one thing I didn't try. Let's resume Windows. Oh, that was two CPUs. Oh, the one is in the 1%. Yeah, I use Lua from time to time. I don't like it much. I always get frustrated with Lua. I'm like, oh, Lua. Yeah, well, they had the meditate skill for sure. Let me show you this little thread that I'm talking about. Steam community announcements and stuff. Discussions. Am I stuck? So here's the screenshot. Oh, he was standing pretty close to the door. See, he had the meditate skill. And he says he used it. And so did the other player. So this is reported by two players. both this morning. They're like, this is what happened. See, and he also mentions that neat effects go off, and so did the other player too, which means, and the other player described it pretty clearly. He's like, the meditation animation happened, but the door didn't open. So both of them, this happened in exactly the same way. The animation happened, but the door didn't open. Oh, right. So if on Windows, if I change this, so doesn't have the meditate. And I run it on Windows. Third chimes? It's gonna be the third time, huh? No! Are there any other conditions that require? Yeah, I was just looking at that. Yeah, I was just looking at that. I was just looking at all the logic behind it, and it seems okay. The one last thing I didn't look at was the open doors actual part here. Couldn't the door have had a start time already? Oh, wait a minute. What if we try and get it to, like, flash? Or do they flash? All right, I want to try this one thing. If I don't have the meditate skill. Yeah, fourth time's the charm. Yeah, King Nothing, that's what I did. I started with that player's actual saves file. So this is their save file. This is exactly what they experienced. This is all their exact game data. So let's try it here from this bit where we actually talk to the guy, gives us meditate. Could the item flux have still been running? Okay, so it doesn't seem to be like a Windows specific thing. I'm just gonna close this. I'm thinking, what if? See, this is, I'm just noticing this in the logic for open doors. It checks if the system is fluxing. Let's put on story verbosity so we can see what flux is running, and perhaps, just maybe, the player tried to go to the menu or something during that. Timing, possibly. From where the one item disappears till the door animation fires. Could be. I need to shorten this dialogue. Or maybe not. See, right here, it's running a flux item. What if I go F to use it and then yeah, you can go into the menu. This could be it, or pause. Ah, see there, it broke it. Wait, no, it didn't break it. Oh. What the hell? I think that did kind of break it, though. Let's see if I stay paused or something. So there, I'm pausing. I'm just gonna let him do this animation and run it all out. Oh, it's still open. The gear menu. Maybe I should, you know what? Maybe I should just do this a different way. Like, I'm giving the player the item. And then I'm taking it away. What if I don't even take it away? Right, just give the player the switch item. So this door will open up every time after this. That would make sense, right? You really should only have to meditate in front of this door once. Not that it should matter what version of Windows. I don't know what version of Windows the players were playing on, but I was just on Windows 7 there. And it was two people. I would imagine it was Windows 10, but you never know. Off the screen and come back on. It should just open back up. When's the BIOS port coming? And Amiga and Atari. Wait a minute. One thing I did notice from another player was that they had killed every single one of these pillars. I don't think that would affect it. You know what? This is probably the way to go. Just keep the doors open. In fact, if I didn't have it that way, and you know what? I should make this a little smarter here too. So it does everything except for that. Like it always gives the player this item. I really think that is unnecessary there. You want to get an Amiga? Cool. That's what you want for Christmas. There you go. So you can pause during a flux, but it doesn't pause the actual flux time. You mean the game time? It does actually keep the... When you press the pause... When you use the pause button, it does pause your game time. So that if player... It's like if a player is playing in permadeath mode and they're watching their time exactly or they're doing a speed run, pausing the game actually does stop your time, but the gear menu keeps your time running. Oh, you mean the animation kept running? Now that part's kind of the way the game is. Yeah, I know what you mean. Like it probably is kind of a, it opens the game up to bugs like crazy, like, doesn't it? I don't know. I wanted to keep, so some fluxes do need to be able to keep animations running, but some fluxes, like the pause flux, you really should pause everything. I don't know. I kind of wanted to see something still going on and tiny little animations on the screen when you're paused, but maybe it really should just totally pause the whole game. I don't know. It's a good point. But Steve, you're asking about the cartridge thing. The cartridge, it's kind of weird, but they got really shady. They apparently went to some gaming conference and showed an actual console that was just a Super Nintendo with a cardboard box on top of it. Like, here's our thing. This is what we want to put out. I don't know. That's a rumor. Maybe that's wrong, but I don't know. It all kind of fizzled and died. And what we're talking about here is this new... It was actually a really good idea. And in fact, I think that someday it would still be a great idea. I think it just needs the right company to do it. But it's a console-based gaming system. I really miss console-based gaming systems. Or, I mean, cartridge-based gaming systems. I think it's a cool idea to bring that back and to do cartridges again. I really do hope some company that's got their stuff together can do that and do it right. Yeah, totally, Mr. Frenick. I really am opening myself up to bugs there. Yeah, I know. I mean, that's what I heard. That might not be true, but like... Retro VGS cardboard. Yeah, this is the article I found on it. It's from motherboard.vice. Made out of tape, cardboard, fake circuits. But really, they actually went to a conference and looked at the back of the console, and it was just literally cardboard on top. I don't know. I think they just couldn't get their hardware together on this. You know, I really think it was a good idea. Let's make a new game engine, then a cartridge open source console. Yes! We have tons of free time. What's up, Wild Chat? Okay, I don't know what happened to these players to get this door to lock, but I think this new code is going to be better. I just need to check this one thing. If I set this back to zero, and I do have the meditate to start. Whew, I'm starving. I gotta get some dinner. But yeah, I'm gonna check this one last thing here. So if I use the meditate skill, open up the door, go up to the next room, come back into that room, I think it will still be locked. So I sit here and meditate. Still locked, so you would have to meditate again right here. This is kind of a stupid way to do it, anyways. It's much better to actually just let the player keep that item. Essentially, you give him the switch to 8, which will keep that door open all the time. So I think this is a much more rock solid code. First of all, it does this check for world pause after it gives you the item, and second of all, it locks the doors and opens the doors so that if a player were to do this, they would still have that item, they could save that way, and the doors would just open the next time like this. Wouldn't it, Mr. Frenick? I think it's a kick-ass idea. It just needs the right company, the right people to like make that happen. I think it would take on with players. I think there's enough players out there that would want a cartridge-based system. And in fact, Retro VGS had a ton of fans. People are really excited about it. It's just that they couldn't get the hardware to work. Or they, I don't know, their team, something like that. Right, so there I meditate. If I go off the screen, come back, the door will open back up. And also if I save and then start again, I'll have this switch to 8 now so that it'll open the door. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna leave it like that. I think this bug might be fixed now. I've handled, I think, what should be. Logically, this should be fixed for players. So, anyways, I'm gonna leave it like that, call it good, and that's gonna be it for today's stream. So, I'm gonna get some dinner in my belly. Thanks a lot for watching, everybody, and it was good chatting about all the stuff we chatted about today. And once again, thanks a lot. Cool, check that out. So see you, everybody. Have a great night. I'll be back tomorrow.